In this next episode, I'll talk about configurations of DED processes and some pros and cons. In the video, you've just seen that powder was used, but there's also a different form of material, and that is a wire. So if we look here, we can use metal powder and a metal wire, and we have three different heat sources, a laser, an electron beam, and plasma or electric arc. I have pictures of just two of the variations that are the most common. The laser, you've already seen the schematic here, and a schematic of the electron beam together with a wire. And you see that almost looks like arc welding, where the wire is fed and the melt pool is created exactly at that spot. But instead of thinking of welding, where you put one line down or even do just dots, this is a continuous process where you've built more or less a whole part just out of weld lines. That already takes us to advantages and disadvantages. The metal are end-use parts with properties comparable to cast or wrought material, much faster and larger than powder bed fusion. It's really a rapid process. Can be applied to pre-existing part features. That was one of the reasons it was invented. You can use it for repairs. You take a metal part out of service and you put it in your machine and you can actually fuse, weld your part back together almost as new. It's mostly combined with multi-axis CNC head or an articulated arm so that you need no support structure. And multi-material deposition is possible, as we saw in the video, and that helps us to reduce material waste. Disadvantages, we definitely have a stair step surface structure because it's a welding process, much more similar to material extrusion in the way the parts look in the stair step structure. Post-processing is required, obviously to get it off the build plate, it's welded to that build plate, but also to get a smooth surface. And often this machining is now combined with the additive portion of it in a hybrid process. So it's sometimes referred to as additive subtractive manufacturing. And we need heat treatment afterwards. We don't get a complete phase change at the interface of the pre-existing material and the newly deposited material. And the bond line has dissimilar material properties, even if the two materials are the same. That's just the temperature gradient and the way the process works.